Hey, what's up, guys? It's Michelle Diaz back with another episode on CC Go. And today I have a very special guest. You know what? Actually, I'm going to let you introduce yourself.
Hey, man, you are now rocking with the biggest here at CCM, man. The biggest speaker, the biggest stuffer. Your baby mama favorite, man. Well, how y'all doing? I'm happy to be here.
So how are you feeling today?
I'm feeling good, man. I'm glad to be behind in front of this camera, under these lights, you know. Feeling real
how's
special.
How's your experience so far?
It's going real good. Everybody real friendly, real nice. Everything's very informative. It's no, you know, no lack of conversation. You're
okay.
Gonna learn something.
Cool. So for the people that don't know you, can you talk a little bit about yourself, who you are, what you do?
Well, as you can see, I'm just a regular old big handsome fella, you know. You know, I stay out of people's way. I'm just here trying to expand my horizon, you know. I'm a hard worker. I'm here to promote things here at CCN. So if there's anything promotion-wise going on, I'll be the face of that. I'll be doing my own content. I'm working on a podcast. I'm working on a few different things here. So just here to try everything and learn a lot.
Okay, and for your podcast, what are your plans for the podcast?
Well, the plans for the podcast is basically, it's going to be called Speak On It. You know what I'm saying? We can speak on it, basically. So what we can speak on is everything. I want everybody to know, to feel included. You know, I want everybody to know we all going through something. We all had those thoughts, you know, whether if it's good or bad, positive, you know. I just want to include everyone. I want to promote my heavyset people for one, because I feel like it ain't no big, handsome guy being the forefront of these things. So I want to stand out there and let them know it can be done. You can be big, fly, and handsome, you know what I'm saying?
Okay,
so this
okay.
What I'm here promoting. This what I'm all about,
him.
You know? Yeah, y'all get into it. Yeah.
Talk to them. Okay, so that's cool. So you said that you're starting your podcast, and then you said you're doing promotions for CCN. How's that going?
That's going good. It's different, you know, from being at home on your ring light. But when you up here, I'm talking about they have a big production team, so you really got to know what you're talking about. And if you're not doing something right, they're gonna let you know. But it's very encouraging, you know. It's not, you know, nothing strange. But you know, I've been learning a lot. I'm trying to get my little professionalism going on, trying to upgrade myself, sit up straight, speak proper, you know. Yeah.
Okay. And right now we're both just chilling.
Yeah, yeah, we're very relaxed right now. You
know, we'll start the professional next week.
Yeah, we're gonna get that in next week. We just at home, just having a conversation today. You know, just an introduction.
So I know we had talked earlier. And you have a TikTok.
Oh, you have
a platform on there. So can you talk to me a little bit what you do on your TikTok, Mr. TikToker?
Well, my TikTok is the biggest, _95. Everything is spelled regular, how you learned it in high school. So yeah. So go out and follow your boy. I'm the biggest, _95 on TikTok as well as Instagram. So on there, I promote a lot of different things. I promote myself, self-care, you know, as far as men. Being not too masculine, still going to get your nails done, you know, get you a facial, make sure you stay well-grown, make sure you got a good presentation when
taking
a woman look at you.
Taking care of yourself doesn't make you less of a man.
For sure. Man, you better tell them. You know,
hey, that's how you grab the ladies, with some nice nails. Nobody wants a man with some dirty fingernails, acne on your face.
Talk to him. Okay. So, yeah, just kind of promoting, you know, a lot of positive things, you know, because I feel like men scared to speak on certain things. Everybody want to be so macho. So I get on there, I act silly, I cook. A lot of men feel like they only got one place in the household. And I'm like, nah, my mama didn't play them. She ain't play them games. You cleaning the toilet and you finna know how to cook breakfast in the morning at a young age. So a lot of women love me for that. Yeah, man, I got to give thanks to my mom. My sister dressed me, and my mama taught me how to maneuver out here. So yeah, that's
okay.
How we doing.
Yeah. Okay.
So y'all go follow me. Make sure.
Did you have brothers? Sorry, we're going off topic. But did you have brothers growing up, or was it just a female like household, and you were the?
Well, I had a very strong father. My father's been with me here day one, dad. You know, from beginning to the end, and we ain't at the end. We ain't nowhere near that. And I had my mom and my sister, and it's just us two, just me and my sister, no brothers. So. All my brothers are met in the neighborhood, you know, in their school, and we locked in like that. But nah, never had no brothers.
So, who are you?
Who am I? Man, story to be told and written. I'd say I'm not your regular guy. You know, I feel a lot of things. You know, I didn't experience a lot in my short life here. You know, I ain't been on this earth for 28 years, but I work hard. I was taught to work hard. So I've been working since I was 16. I started at the carnival, you know, $8 an hour.
So, $8?
$8 at the carnival, 12-hour shifts. Do you
hear me? I'm over here complaining about $12 an hour.
So that's what I'm trying to tell you. So, yeah. So I worked at the carnival. I worked at different warehouses, and I ended up at the city of Houston. That's your grown man money. That's when I was entering adulthood. And I said, Mama, I'm finna move out. I'm making $1,000, so I'm good. I thought I was ready. Was not ready for these bills. When these bills started, they did not stop. So I've been working at the city for 8 years, and that's been a life learning experience, because I've met a lot of older men, and they asked me for a lot of advice with their kids and their children. I'm like, man, I don't got no kids. But they were like, man, 5 years ago, you was in high school. So I'm like, all right, I'll tell you what I can. Sir.
Sir.
But I'm like, you know, but it's all good. So yeah, it's just been a journey, you know. It's, you know, meeting different women, learning different things. Cause I like, you know, older women my age, you know. So,
yeah. Sugar mama.
So, man, if you need a sugar baby, come on. If you got some honey over there, let me be your teddy bear. You know, I'm with all that.
You heard it here first. Me and...
The biggest. The big way, baby. Real big speaker.
We are putting in our applications for sugar baby.
Come on, sugar mama. Come give me, baby.
I'm so sorry. Well, man, I had another question, but we always get off topic. I'm so sorry. Oh, anyway, so you told me a little bit about yourself. And so you moved out and everything. And so how do you feel when you made that transition from going, you know, being at home, you know, with your mom, and then, like you say, you felt like you weren't ready? Why is that? Why did you feel?
No, I felt like I was ready. But when I got out there, I was like, yeah, you bit off a lot. You know, it's a lot to handle. You know, keeping up with your bills, keeping up with your car payment, the maintenance on your car, keeping your spot clean. It's a lot. I don't know no men right now that's under the age of 30 that can go out and just grocery shop. That's simple. But that's stuff you got to learn. That's some life stuff. Everybody, you know, you're depending on a woman or your mama or, you know, or your big brother. But it was just a lot to learn, how to budget, how much did we spend here. You know, it ain't no blueprint for that. Everybody got their own journey. And me, I learned from trial and error. My mama told me as a young age, well, I could tell you that pot hot and you still gonna touch it. Cause I just gotta touch it. Yeah. They ain't make me move out. I was like, Mama, I'm ready to have these women over here and have me a little girlfriend. So at 18, I said, I'm gone. Let me go and go see. And that pot was hot out there. Do you hear me? But, you know, slowly as you grow older, you learn. You live and you learn. So it's been a good experience. I advise everybody, men and women, move out. Go live on your own before you be waiting on, you know, your partner and all that. See how I feel to be independent. See how you keep a house. Are you a clean person or are you a weirdo? Because some days I don't even talk till I go to work. I just be in the house quiet, just doing what I do. You never know stuff like that if you don't live with nobody.
And how do you feel? What is something, you know, I'm pretty sure you had your hard days. So what is something that kept you pushing that you would like to share to the audience? Because I'm pretty sure, I mean, everybody, you know, everybody has moved out. I've moved out. I've known what it's like living on my own. And I couldn't do it. I had to go back to my grandparents because, you know, it's hard out here. Inflation is crazy. But is there anything that, you know, got you out of bed, got you, you know, because it's not easy for you to get up and then teach yourself to do something. You know, we all have our lazy days and we all feel a little stuck sometimes. So what is something that helped you get to where you are right now?
I would say, for one thing, you got to have faith. You got to have faith in something. You got to have faith in yourself, for one. And if you're blessed to have a good family behind you, you know, that can motivate you as well. Because my family, they want to see me do better. And I want to see me do better. So, you know, that kind of keep me going and make me not give up. Just kind of, you know, having faith in myself and having that support system for my family. But if you do not have your family in your life, do not let that be an excuse to go out here and do something you ain't got no business or just crash out. Please don't do that. Just sit with yourself, say you a prayer to whoever you pray to or whatever, and just work hard, stay with it, don't give up, and try. This is what I'm doing as fluently and as good as this look. This is me trying. Try something different. Whether you pass or fail, try. Because you don't want to wake up and you 50 and you never try. Do what you like to do, as long as it's legal, and try. And try.
I want to close up on get his up face. And try.
I'm talking about it. Just get out there and try, man. Give it a try, man. That's my message. Try. T-R-Y. Try.
Well, I think that's the best way to close it out. So thank you guys so much for watching another episode of CC Go. And make sure to like, subscribe, comment, and share, because we have another guest coming next week. So make sure y'all are up to date on who's coming next on CC Go. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure having you here. Wishing you the best on everything.
I appreciate it. Thanks for having me.
All right. Bye, guys.